Welcome to Azure Essentials, an important part of cloud security is configuring who can access and manage your cloud resources. Identity and access for Microsoft Azure is one of the most pivotal things to learn as an Azure user. And in the next few minutes, I'll walk you through the essential things that you need to know in this area. Now, at the heart of identity and access management for Azure is Azure Active Directory. This is the identity system for Azure. Every Azure subscription trusts an Azure AD tenant for sign-in, and multiple subscriptions can trust a single Azure AD tenant. In the Azure portal, you can view and manage the users and groups in the directory that can be granted access to Azure resources. You can also view sign-in activity and other audit logs. Azure AD can be managed from the portal, PowerShell, the Azure CLI, and programmatically using the Microsoft Graph API. It's important to note that Azure AD is the identity system for all Microsoft Business Cloud services, such as Office 365, Dynamics 365, and Microsoft Intune. If your organization already has Azure Active Directory, you can use that to sign into Azure. And if you create an Azure subscription using your personal Microsoft account, then a new Azure AD tenant's created for you, and your subscription trusts that tenant. Now, an important tip here is, if you've already got an Azure AD work account that you use with Office 365 or other Microsoft services, you can transfer your subscription from your personal account to your work account, which will also move it to your work Azure AD tenant. You can find out more on how to do this, including how to create a subscription using your Azure AD work account at the link shown. Now, if you've got an on-premises Active Directory, it's easy to connect it with Azure Active Directory to create a hybrid directory with a single point of management. Using the Azure AD Connect tool, you can synchronize users between AD and Azure AD so that they can be managed in one place. You can choose from a variety of options for reduced sign-on or single sign-in, including hash password sync, pass-through authentication, and standards-based federation using a federation server such as Active Directory Federation Services. Connecting your Active Directory to Azure AD can reduce management effort and make it easier to comply with policy. Now, controlling access to Azure resources is achieved by using role-based access control, or RBAC. With Azure RBAC, you can grant users the ability to take specific actions on a specific set of resources. Azure comes with three main built-in roles: the owner, contributor, and reader. The owner role can perform all actions on all resource types. The contributor role is similar to the owner role, except it doesn't allow for managing RBAC itself. And finally, the reader role can perform all read actions on all resource types. Azure also provides a set of resource-specific built-in roles for more granular control. For example, the VM contributor role can perform all actions on VMs, but can't perform actions on any other resource type, such as networking. This makes it possible to separate the people who can manage network resources from the people who can manage VM resources. Using Azure RBAC, you can also create custom roles that align exactly to your team's responsibilities. Custom roles can be created using the command line or Azure Resource Manager API. You can grant access to resources by assigning a user, group, or service principal, such as a process or an application, to a specific role at a specific scope. The scope can be at the level of the subscription, a resource group, or an individual resource such as a VM. When a role assignment is made on a subscription or resource group, the assignment is inherited by the resources within that scope. Let me give you an example. If you've been assigned the owner role at the subscription scope, then you have full access to all the resource groups and resources within that subscription. If you've been assigned the owner role at the resource group scope, then you have full access to all resources within that specific resource group. Again, you can manage role assignments using the portal, command line tools, and the Azure Resource Manager API. In addition to controlling access, you can track actions happening in the system with the activity log that will show you subscription level events, including the RBAC changes. Now, one thing a lot of Azure users want to know is how to grant access to people from outside their organization. Now, we enable that with Azure Active Directory B2B. How this works is you enter a person's email address when making a role assignment. Azure will then invite the user to become a guest in your Azure AD. Now, by default, all users can invite guests, but you can also control who can make guest invitations. If your user account has been granted access to an Azure subscription from another organization, then you can manage that subscription by switching to the other organization's directory using the sign-in control in the portal. Lastly, to help you protect your user accounts, Azure Active Directory supports a range of multi-factor authentication methods, including phone call, SMS message, or by using the Microsoft Authenticator mobile app. Additionally, using the Azure AD Premium Conditional Access feature, you can configure multi-factor authentication to be required only under certain conditions, such as when users are accessing Azure from home, or while traveling, and are not on the work network. In fact, there's a lot that I encourage you to explore in Conditional Access, For example, you can require multi-factor authentication based on the user's sign-in risk level, and you can limit access to only users on managed devices. I hope this overview helps you understand the essentials of identity and access for Azure. It's a critical area to understand as an Azure user, and you can learn more with virtual demo experiences at the link shown. And of course, keep checking back to Azure Essentials for additional topics.